The other one was Hong Kong. And today, with everything that's going on, I kind of imagine it, because as I mentioned, the very first, when they opened up independent travel to Americans, I came, went to Beijing, I was between ships, had a little bit of leave, and came out a couple weeks later down in Hong Kong. And man, I mean, I was on a sheep boat, basically, to get through. No, there's no tourist boats to go from Wuhan to Chongqing. I was there with a sheep, and it cost me the equivalent of $1 a day to be able to sleep with the sheep and get a bowl of rice or something. But I could splurge for about $1.25 and have a room like this with about 25 people laying on a straw mat. I splurged and went with the straw mat, all right? And we went through the Yangtze River. And it was fascinating. And I haven't been back, been to Mongolia. But I didn't know I found it so exotic and everything, and the people are wonderful. When I came out to Hong Kong, for whatever reason, and I'd been there in a port, after going through a country at that time, and maybe it was of the moment, but Hong Kong, with its vibrancy, and at the time it was still under British rule, of just be all you can be with no restraints on it, light shining. Okay, I got climate change, but at the moment, you know, it was just exciting. For some reason, I never lost that zeal whenever I went back to Hong Kong on a ship or something. And I don't know how it is today, but those are the two that